This is verse 5 of the 11th chapter of the Gospel of John. Jesus is on a portion of the Jordan River where John the Baptist had carried on his ministry at an earlier time. Jesus presumably is there now preaching, and his disciples, at least we gather from other sources, were baptizing people, probably in the same spirit as John the Baptist had, a baptism unto repentance. But while he's there in that status, he receives word that his friend Lazarus is ill. The word comes from Martha and Mary, these two sisters of Lazarus who are hopeful that Jesus can come and intervene in what seems to be a very serious situation. Jesus assures his disciples that the illness that's being suffered by Lazarus is not unto death. Pros thanaton is the way that John puts it, meaning not ultimately unto death, although certainly in the short term, Lazarus does indeed die. And then he adds this interesting editorial comment here. We have agapa. This is from agapao, the word for I love, the contract verb. This is the third person singular, imperfect active indicative, so it gives the impression of an ongoing relationship. You might render it, Jesus was loving, was the idea, in other words, had been and continued to love these people, this family that we're referring to here. De, the postpositive, a soft conjunction, but Jesus was loving, then ho Jesus, the subject of the verb, Jesus was loving. Tain marthon, the article customarily used in Greek, especially when there's a particular distinct person in view, as there is here. So Jesus literally loved the Martha. We render it simply loved marthon, kai, tain, adelphain, and the sister is the word here. Mary is not mentioned by name. Tain adelphain autes, the feminine genitive singular pronoun, and the sister of her, kai, tone, and then finally, lazarone. It really is interesting that the comment is made. It tells us, of course, that there was an ongoing relationship between Jesus and these siblings. It also tells us, of course, that the reports that we give from the New Testament, while they're certainly accurate insofar as that which they report, they're not comprehensive. That there's a whole lot of the story of Jesus that we don't know because it wasn't in the interest of the authors of the New Testament to include it. And certainly one detail that is of interest here is that Jesus manifestly had an ongoing relationship, had presumably been in their home on multiple occasions, and that this was a friendship as well as a relationship between those who were the worshipers of Christ and, from his point of view, those who were members of his flock.